Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Theft of Archimedes Pendulum. Chapter 1. The Mysterious Heist. In the heart of Athens, beneath the watchful gaze of the Acropolis, the Greek National Museum was a fortress of history and culture. Its latest exhibit, featuring Archimedes' legendary pendulum, had attracted scholars and enthusiasts from around the world. The pendulum, a marvel of ancient engineering, was believed to demonstrate principles of antigravity, a testament to Archimedes' genius. Its theft was not just a loss of a relic, it was a blow to cultural heritage. Detective Elena Stavros, with her keen eye for detail and profound knowledge of ancient artifacts, was the obvious choice for the investigation. Her reputation for solving the most intricate cases preceded her as she stepped into the museum, now a crime scene. The heist was clean, precise, with no obvious signs of forced entry. The thief, or thieves, had bypassed state-of-the-art security systems, leaving behind only a web of mystery. Elena meticulously examined the glass case that housed the pendulum. It was evident that the culprit had knowledge of advanced technologies, possibly rivaling that of the ancient inventor himself. Elena's first lead came from the security footage. The cameras had captured a hooded figure moving through the museum with an uncanny familiarity with the building's layout. This figure navigated the security with ease, avoiding cameras and sensors as if aware of their every placement. Compelled to delve deeper, Elena visited the museum's archives. She pored over documents detailing the pendulum's discovery, a fortuitous find in an underwater excavation near Syracuse, Archimedes' birthplace. The documents revealed that several parties had shown immense interest in the pendulum, some with intentions that seemed beyond scholarly. Elena's next step led her into the heart of Athens, where she tapped into her network of informants. The bustling city, a blend of ancient architecture and modern hustle, was a treasure trove of information for those who knew where to look. In the shadowy corners of the Plaka district, Elena met with an informant who hinted at the involvement of an elusive figure known as the Collector, a person shrouded in mystery, known for their obsession with acquiring rare and powerful artifacts. Armed with this new information, Elena delved into the underground world of black market antiquities. Her search brought her to a discreet auction in a secluded mansion where ancient artifacts changed hands for fortunes. It was a world where history was commodified and relics were stripped of their cultural significance. Amidst the clandestine gathering, Elena picked up whispers of a pending sale of an item that could change the balance of power. She suspected they were referring to Archimedes' pendulum. Her suspicion was confirmed when she discreetly obtained a list of upcoming items for auction, which included a cryptic reference to an Archimedean artifact. The trail then led Elena to the island of Crete. The informant had mentioned that the collector had ties to the island and often used it as a base for their illicit dealings. Crete, with its rich Minoan history and labyrinthine palaces, was a fitting backdrop for what was turning into a chase for one of history's greatest mysteries. Upon reaching Crete, Elena's first visit was to the ancient ruins of Knossos. Amidst the remnants of the Minoan civilization, she hoped to find clues that would lead her to the collector. She explored the archaeological site, her mind piecing together the history of the place with the puzzle she was trying to solve. As she wandered through the ancient ruins, Elena felt a deep connection to the past. The Minoans, a civilization that had flourished thousands of years ago, had left behind a legacy of art, architecture, and mystery. It was here, in the silence of the ruins, that Elena realized the true value of what she was chasing. Archimedes' pendulum was not just a relic, it was a link to a past that continued to shape the present. Her contemplation was cut short by a sudden realization. She had been followed. A shadowy figure watched her from a distance, blending into the labyrinth of ancient walls. Elena knew that her investigation had stirred the waters, attracting the attention of those who sought the pendulum for their ends. As the sun set over the ruins of Knossos, Elena prepared for the next phase of her investigation. She was no longer just a detective chasing a thief, she was a guardian of history, racing against time to prevent a priceless piece of the past from falling into the wrong hands. The mystery of Archimedes' pendulum had taken her on a journey that traversed history and mythology, and Elena was determined to see it through to the end. Chapter 2. Chasing Shadows. Detective Elena Stavros' investigation in Athens had led her to a trail that pointed unmistakably to Crete, the island known as much for its ancient Minoan palaces as for its labyrinthine connections to the modern black market of antiquities. The suspect, known only as the collector, remained an enigma, a shadow operating in the murky underworld where history's treasures were traded like commodities. On the bustling streets of Heraklion, Crete's capital, Elena's instincts as a detective were heightened. She knew that in the world of illegal antiquities, trust was a scarce commodity, and danger lurked in unexpected corners. Her first stop was the Archaeological Museum of Heraklion, a treasure trove of Minoan artifacts. There, amidst the relics of a bygone era, she met with Dr. Nikos Petrakis, an expert in Minoan history, who provided valuable insights into the kind of person who would be interested in Archimedes' pendulum. Dr. Petrakis explained that to some, such artifacts were not merely historical objects, but were believed to hold esoteric knowledge and power. Equipped with this new understanding, Elena ventured into the less frequented parts of the city. In the shadow of the ancient Venetian fortress that overlooked the harbor, she encountered informants who spoke in hushed tones about the collector's recent activities. They hinted at a secretive auction where the pendulum was rumored to be the centerpiece. The auction, they said, was to take place in a secluded villa known to a select few. Navigating a complex web of contacts, Elena secured an invitation to the auction. Disguised and using a false identity, she entered a world where the past was bought and sold to the highest bidder. The villa was filled with an eclectic mix of people, wealthy collectors, historians turned rogues, and others with less discernible intentions. As the auction commenced, Elena watched intently, analyzing each participant, searching for any sign that could lead her to the collector. Item after item of dubious provenance was presented and eagerly snapped up. And then, with a dramatic flair, the auctioneer unveiled the pendulum. It lay upon a velvet cushion, its surface catching the light, casting an ethereal glow around the room. The bidding was intense, a rapid exchange of offers that escalated quickly. But before a sale could be finalized, chaos erupted. Armed men, presumably working for the collector, stormed the villa, their intent clear, to seize the pendulum by force. In the ensuing melee, Elena fought her way to the pendulum. Her skills in combat, honed over years of field work, were matched only by her determination to protect the invaluable artifact. As she secured the pendulum, she caught a glimpse of a figure, a man watching the chaos with a calculated gaze. She had no doubt this was the collector. Amidst the confusion, Elena made a daring escape, pendulum in hand. But the encounter had raised the stakes. The collector was not just a thief or a black market dealer. He was someone with resources, connections, and a deep understanding of the artifact's value. With the pendulum now in her possession, Elena knew she needed to uncover its secrets before the collector made another move. She returned to Dr. Petrakis, seeking his expertise. Together, they examined the pendulum, discovering intricate mechanisms and engravings that hinted at knowledge far ahead of its time. Dr. Petrakis suggested that the pendulum might be connected to the ancient antikythera mechanism, another example of advanced ancient Greek technology. If true, the pendulum was more than a historical artifact. It was a key to understanding the technological prowess of the ancients. But time was a luxury Elena did not have. The collector was still at large, and his intentions for the pendulum were undoubtedly nefarious. Elena realized she needed to delve deeper into the underground world where history and greed intersected. Her investigation took her across Crete to remote villages and hidden archaeological sites, where she uncovered a network that the collector had built over the years. She learned of his obsession with ancient technologies and his belief that such artifacts could grant him power and influence beyond measure. As Elena pieced together the puzzle, she prepared for a final confrontation. The collector, she knew, would not give up easily. He had shown that he was willing to go to great lengths to claim the pendulum, and Elena was the only thing standing in his way. The chase had become more than just a mission to recover a stolen artifact. It was a battle to protect a piece of history from being twisted by modern ambition and greed. As she braced for the final showdown, Elena understood that the true power of Archimedes' pendulum lay not in the artifact itself, but in the knowledge and legacy it represented, a legacy that she was determined to preserve for future generations. Chapter 3. The Labyrinth of Gnosis. Detective Elena Stavros' journey led her to the labyrinth and ruins of the ancient palace of Gnosis, a place steeped in legend and history. The sprawling complex, with its intricate network of rooms and corridors, mirrored the complexity of the case she was unraveling. In the shadow of these ancient Minoan ruins, Elena felt as if she were walking alongside history itself. Her exploration of the site was methodical. The palace, with its frescoes and artifacts, spoke of a civilization that had flourished thousands of years ago. As she wandered through the ruins, Elena pondered the connection between this ancient site and the pendulum. It was here, in this maze of history, that she hoped to find clues to the collector's motives and perhaps even the location of the pendulum itself. Elena's investigation in Knossos took an unexpected turn when she discovered a series of hidden symbols etched discreetly into the walls of the palace. These symbols, which appeared to be of Minoan origin, seemed to form a cryptic map. With her knowledge of ancient civilizations, Elena deciphered the map, revealing a path that led deeper into the ruins to a chamber that had remained hidden from the eyes of modern archaeologists. As she followed the map, navigating the labyrinthine corridors, Elena couldn't shake the feeling that she was being watched. The collector, she suspected, was always one step ahead, using the ruins as a playing field for this high-stakes game of cat and mouse. In the hidden chamber, Elena found more than just Minoan relics. There were items from various periods of Greek history, including what appeared to be prototypes of Archimedes' inventions. This collection, she realized, was the collector's private museum, a hoard of stolen artifacts gathered from across the ages. Among the collection, Elena finally found the pendulum. Its presence among the other artifacts confirmed her suspicion that the collector was not just a thief, but a connoisseur of history, albeit one with a twisted sense of ownership over the past. But the discovery of the pendulum was not the end of Elena's journey. As she reached for the artifact, she was ambushed by the collector's henchmen. A struggle ensued, testing Elena's physical and mental prowess. She managed to outmaneuver her attackers, securing the pendulum and escaping the chamber, but not without sustaining injuries. Wounded but determined, Elena knew she had to confront the collector directly. Her clues led her to a secluded villa on the outskirts of Heraklion, where she believed the collector was hiding. The confrontation at the villa was tense and revealing. The collector, unmasked, was indeed a figure known in the world of archaeology, a scholar who had turned to the shadows, disillusioned by the commercialization and politicization of historical artifacts. His motives, though misguided, stemmed from a desire to preserve history in his way. Elena engaged the collector in a battle of wits, debating the ethics of artifact preservation and the true meaning of history. She argued that artifacts like the pendulum belonged to humanity and should be shared with the world, not hoarded for personal gain. As their conversation unfolded, it became clear that the collector was not going to surrender easily. But Elena, with her unwavering commitment to justice and history, managed to persuade him to see reason. She promised that the pendulum would be returned to a place where it could be studied and appreciated in the context of its historical significance. The collector, defeated and disillusioned, agreed to cease his pursuit of the pendulum. Elena emerged from the villa with the artifact in hand, ready to return it to its rightful place in the Greek National Museum. As she prepared to leave Crete, Elena reflected on her journey. She had delved into the depths of ancient history, confronted modern-day greed, and emerged victorious. But more importantly, she had ensured that a priceless piece of the past would continue to inspire and educate future generations. The case of the theft of Archimedes' pendulum was closed, but for Detective Elena Stavros, the adventure had reaffirmed her belief in the power and importance of preserving history. as she boarded the plane back to Athens with the pendulum secured in its case, she felt a sense of accomplishment and a renewed dedication to her role as a protector of the past. Chapter 4. Unveiling the Truth. Back in Athens, with Archimedes' pendulum safely in her possession, Detective Elena Stavros faced the task of unraveling the last threads of the mystery. The journey had taken her from the bustling streets of Athens to the ancient ruins of Crete, and finally, to a confrontation with the collector. Now, it was time to reveal the full story behind the pendulum's theft and ensure its safe return to the Greek National Museum. Elena's return to Athens was marked by a mix of relief and anticipation. The pendulum, an artifact of immense historical and scientific value, was more than just a stolen object to be returned. It was a symbol of the enduring legacy of Greek civilization, a tangible link to the genius of Archimedes. Before returning the pendulum to the museum, Elena sought the expertise of Dr. Ilias Metaxas, a renowned physicist and historian. Together, they examined the pendulum in a secure laboratory, uncovering the intricacies of its design and the principles of antigravity it demonstrated. Dr. Metaxas confirmed that the pendulum was indeed a groundbreaking invention, far ahead of its time. Its recovery was not just a triumph for law enforcement, but a significant moment for the scientific community. With the pendulum's authenticity and importance reaffirmed, Elena prepared for a press conference at the museum. The event was attended by media, historians, government officials, and the public, all eager to learn about the pendulum's journey and its return. At the conference, Elena presented a detailed account of her investigation. She revealed the existence of the collector, the underground network of antiquities trading, and the journey that had taken her across Greece. She emphasized the importance of protecting cultural heritage and the dangers posed by those who sought to exploit history for personal gain. The revelation of the collector's identity as a respected archaeologist and scholar shocked the audience. It highlighted the complex ethical dilemmas surrounding artifact preservation and the fine line between passion for history and obsession. As Elena concluded her presentation, she unveiled the pendulum, now securely displayed in a new, state-of-the-art exhibit. The exhibit was designed not only to showcase the pendulum but also to educate visitors about its history, from its creation by Archimedes to its recent recovery. The pendulum's return to the museum was celebrated as a victory for cultural preservation. It sparked a renewed interest in ancient Greek technology and a public discourse on the importance of safeguarding historical artifacts. For Elena, the case of the theft of Archimedes' pendulum was a defining moment in her career. It had taken her on a journey through the annals of history, pitting her against formidable opponents and challenging her both intellectually and physically. In the days following the press conference, Elena received commendations for her work. But for her, the true reward was the knowledge that she had played a part in preserving a piece of history for future generations. The case also strengthened her resolve to continue her work in protecting cultural heritage. She knew that for every artifact recovered, many more remained lost or hidden, waiting to be found and restored to their rightful place in history. As Elena walked through the halls of the museum, past the exhibit of Archimedes' pendulum, she felt a deep connection to the past. She realized that her role as a detective was not just about solving crimes, but about keeping the stories of the past alive, ensuring that they continue to inspire, educate, and intrigue. The theft of Archimedes' pendulum had been more than just a case. It was a journey into the heart of history, a reminder of the enduring legacy of human ingenuity, and a testament to the timeless value of preserving our cultural heritage.